When James Jameson bought a girl just to watch her be eaten by cannibals, James Jameson used his power and privilege to do the unspeakable and get away with it. In the 1880s, an heir to the vast Jameson Irish whiskey fortune bought a 10-year-old girl just so he could draw her being eaten by cannibals. James S. Jameson was the great-great-grandson of John Jameson, the founder of the famed Irish Whiskey Company, and as such was heir to the family fortune. In 1888, he joined the Emin Pasha Relief Expedition, led by renowned explorer Henry Morton Stanley, across Central Africa. The journey was ostensibly to bring supplies to Emin Pasha, the leader of an Ottoman province in Sudan that was cut off by a. They also say that Jameson were dealing directly with Tiputip, a slave trader and local fixer. According to Asad Farin, a Sudanese translator on the trip, Jameson expressed interest in seeing cannibalism firsthand. Tip then talked to the chiefs of the village and produced a 10-year-old slave girl, who Jameson paid 6 handkerchiefs for. According to a translator, the chiefs then said to their villagers, "This is a present from a white man, who wishes to see her eaten." The girl was tied to a tree, said Farron. The natives sharpened their knives the while. One of them then stabbed her twice in the belly. In James Jameson's own diary he then wrote, "Three men then ran forward, and began to cut up the body of the girl. Finally her head was cut off, and not a particle remained, each man taking his piece away down the river to wash it." Both of them also agree on another count: the girl never screamed throughout the ordeal. The most extraordinary thing was that the girl never uttered a sound, nor struggled, until she fell, wrote Jameson. Jameson, in the meantime, made rough sketches of the horrible scenes, recounted Farad in his later testimony. Jameson afterward went to his tent, where he finished his sketches in watercolors. Likely, the account of his crime is true, but James Jameson never faced justice. He died shortly after the accusations of his misconduct made their way to Stanley in 1888.